We are back with a video. After Kenya's Strongest Man, we have got some psych now. So today is a squat session. So I'm just going to, we're going to take you over our warming up routine for the squat. I usually like to follow a certain warm up routine for the squat. I'll take you guys through it. So if it works for you guys, then that's good. If not, then maybe you can also do your research as well. So this is the first thing that I like to do is I like to warm up my shoulders before a squat. Some people usually argue that this doesn't make sense, but it does, because for you to get into a good position for your squat, for the bar to be on your delt here, you need to be able to have a good stretch in your shoulders. So I normally do a few waves of this motion, of this patrol motion. Just getting the shoulders warmed up. Because today we're also doing waiters walks, and that actually works the shoulders. So we're gonna work everything, and then Mr. Saad can take over while.
Well, there's nothing much I'm going to take over since I'm wearing slippers today. Quite informal, but my shoes were wet. So,
and his shirt is also wet. We don't know what he's been doing.
The bathroom session was very intense after the burger challenge, so it made me sweat. So, just warming up.
And then the next thing that I like to do is, well, for this we have bands. What we like to do is just tie them onto the rack and then stretch the leg as much as possible onto a plate, and then pull the knee in front, so you're getting a stretch in your, maybe if I can show you. You're getting a stretch in your calves, which is good, because you need a lot of good ankle movement, calf and hip in the squat. So this is very important, so getting the calves warmed up. This movement I like because it warms up my hips. So I get the motion of pushing my knees out. So of course the same thing with the other leg. And then the next routine I like to do is I just get a bench. So maybe like this bench here. Put my leg on it, and then this leg I like to point it slightly out. So when you're stretching, your abductors and your hamstring, so you're getting a good stretch there. So again, you can do 10 rounds of that each, 10 reps. You have to really make sure that you warm up well before a squat, because it's a movement that you don't play around with. So after that, what I like to do is, I learned this from Mr. Johan Els. So you just take this bar, this band, put make it into two, and then you lie down. Get it through your leg like that. Hold it here and lie down back, just stretching the hamstring. A really, really good stretch for the hamstring there. You can feel it burn. You can see in our Kenya Strongest Man blog, he was warming up with this movement for the deadlift. It's also a very good warm-up for the hamstrings. Then what I like to do is get a good extension on the hamstring and the hip. Saad has already done that earlier on. So you just grab a bar or whatever you can get your hands on, and then with the support you just go down until when you feel like that's the end, and then you just get a stretch there. And you come back up, and you can do that for a few reps. I've already done it before the filming started. And then the last thing I like to do is get a good stretch in my back. So I go down. And then I get into this position. And just stretch. And then activating the abs, because you need, when you're doing a squat, the bracing, you need to know how to control your abs as well. So I like to do a short plank, just squeezing my glutes, my abs. And we're ready. So warming up with an empty bar. Many people like to jump weights. I don't recommend, unless you know your body really well. I always start up with empty bar and then just progress. Maybe with increase of 20, depends on your body. I normally do a 20 kilo increase.
I'll go Punjabi style.
I'm also going to go barefoot because I don't like squatting in shoes.
Jumping around as well with the weights, not weights yet, but he's trying to activate his calves, his glutes, his hamstrings. So that's what he's trying to do. So you have to activate as much as you can before you start with weights. So people normally really downgrade empty bar exercises because I think they feel small when they do it. That's one of the most important things. At least empty bar, at least 2-3 sets, just to warm yourself up, and you're good to go. Just for breathing, nothing so serious.
Squat socks and deadlift socks, because I don't want to use the new ones and mess them up. So these are run down. So guys, you can see I'm wearing knee sleeves. Sal is also putting on some knee sleeves. What this does is helps the joints stay warm, because if it's cold, that's why working out in cold is very difficult, because your joints, they're all feeling like they're being touched a bit too much. So these help with keeping them warm, and warm throughout, of course, the workout, and also helps them keep safe. So this is our first working set. training, I didn't know how to breathe and brace. So the weights weren't going up. I wasn't improving until I watched a video of Brian Alzru. So big up to him. He taught on his video how to breathe and brace using your core. You know, some people normally do breathe into their chest, but their core is still very loose. So you'll never be able to get to heavy weight. But when you push your core out, so a good way to train this is you wear a belt and then you don't tie the belt that tight. So you try breathing out of the belt when you're breathing in. So basically you're not breathing into your, you are breathing into your chest because you wouldn't be able to breathe then, but you're breathing, you're tightening that core before you go for your rep.
And that's what stretches out the abdomen, and what you think is a big belly is actually just a big slab of meat. It's not, there's no fat there. There is fat, but it's all
muscle. We are kind of fit, kind of fat.
Yeah.
But so the bracing is very important. Whenever I feel like I'm not able to make a rep, I still end up doing it somehow because my breathing and bracing is correct for that set. But if I lose my air, if I lose my breath, then I usually fail on the rep. So that's something that has really helped me during the squat. So check out Brian Alzru's channel as well. A lot of informative videos on how to do the log, how to do the squat, the deadlift, everything. Very, very good guy. Explains every process as it goes. We might not be able to explain very well because his experience is far more than ours. But still trying. So far, what we have attained in terms of experience, we're bringing that out to try and help other newer lifters. Because when we came in, we were also guided by more experienced lifters. So it's just about helping one another.
About breathing in, breathing out, when I was doing my course as well, they teach you that when you're pushing the weight, always breathe out. It's not always the case. The different sports, the different exercises, never, because if while doing like a squat, while you're doing a squat, you breathe out, there's nothing left in you anymore. You can't lift it.
You have to maintain.
You have to maintain it. Release, breathe in, release, breathe in. So you're never supposed to just breathe out, because you'll be left halfway and you'll be falling down.
I'll give you a very good example. Just what he's talked about is very important. When you're doing a farmer's walk and you're walking and you go, you lose the whole core, you drop the weight, you're going to drop the weight on your foot and you're going to be a problem. What you need to do is kind of breathe in and out while still maintaining. It's a very difficult thing to do, but breathing in and out while maintaining tight core is something that you need to practice. Do a lot of breathing exercises. Maybe when you get up in the morning, just breathe, try to hold your core and then breathe out, and then try to breathe in and out while still maintaining. It's like someone's going to punch you, but you're still breathing in and out. So if I come and punch your abs, you're going to have it tight, and I can still talk the way I'm talking, but it's still tight. So that's what you have to just learn.
And always, while you have heavy weights on you and you want to breathe in or out, always use your nose, because you, with your mouth, you tend to release more breath out. So always, if possible, for a starter, if someone doesn't have control, if you're starting to learn this, always use your nose, because you will not be able to exhale so much. So always do that, because if you do with your mouth, if you want to, you have heavy weights on you, or you're running with the weights, you want to release just a bit, you want to exhale a bit. If you try to do it with your mouth, you'll just be tempted. As soon as you breathe out and you're done.
So maybe in the next set, you can be able to see how I breathe and brace. And at every rep, you have to do it the same, even if it's light. So when you're warming up is when you're actually showing your body how to do it, not when it's heavy. So when you're with an empty bar, practice that breathing in, breathing out motion. It's very helpful, guys. So you briefly saw, just breathing in, bracing, very, very important, guys. Make sure you do it, practice it. We're still learning because there are a lot of exercises where we still have to know the breathing in and out. So that's a very important thing to train. So guys, when I went for my last set, when I finished the set, when I was walking, I felt like my back was pulling a bit. So you have to always listen to your body. Sometimes it's not your day at the gym, but doesn't mean you stop training. I always try and work around it. So my next set, I'm going to of course put on a belt and then go for it. But if I feel like it's not working out for me that set, then I usually stop it, move on to something else. Like I'm going to do weighted chin-ups, some waiters walk that are not that heavy. So something I like doing for my back when it's feeling a bit tight is I lie down straight. Say, can you even feel it when I lie down? And then put your hands in that way and stretch as far as you can. And then try and tighten your glutes while doing that. You will feel a good stretch. And then also with this leg straight, bring this leg up and lie down flat, pull it towards your abdomen while the other one is straight, and then hold it in this way and push it towards the side, and I can feel the stretch in my back. And then the same thing with the other one. And if you still feel that your back is still giving you problems, then maybe you can try and do that stretch. And then while lying down straight, this leg over there, and you're pushing.
Just silent today, just a bit silent. When it's that weight on the bar, everyone has to be silent. So time for a bloody belt. Main pong ja raha hai, paani pa ja raha hai. We will definitely put subtitles for whenever we're trying to speak Punjabi. I mean, it's not, English is not our first language, is it?
Isn't actually.
It isn't.
It's
yeah.
Funny because I can speak Punjabi, I can't read it, I can't write it. So, shit at that. Swahili, naezaongea kidogo kidogo, lakini pia siwezi soma. No, actually, naeza soma.
You can, of course.
Hata kuandika naweza. So, Swahili, actually, we are better at Swahili than Punjabi. English, of course, reading and writing is okay.
And
Hindi,
and
my Hindi is amazing.
Oh, the, no, no, no.
Hum udhar ja sakte hai, but I think in that case then English and Swahili probably, because Punjabi I can't read and write.
For me Swahili is okay, English is perfectly okay.
So for our
Punjabi,
Swahili viewers,
Punjabi, I'm a bloody Pendu, all the way from Punjab. I'm a bloody Pendu. Pendu is a villager, so the Asian community will understand, and for the non-Asian community, I'm a villager, I'm a farmer. He's supposed to be a farmer, but he's not. He is actually, but not done farming yet. I'm a typical farmer.
I can't grow anything to save my life.
We are actually farming. You didn't get what I was trying to say.
Farmers walk, yeah. That yes. We are farmers in that way. So for our Kenyan viewers,
Please.
We can also talk in Swahili, which is, we love it.
Swahili si shida mwanangu, si shida. Kama ni kuongea, tunaweza ongea, tutaendelea paka asubuhi tena kesho. so it's never been a problem. My accent is like that because I stayed with my wife. And, well, yeah. What did I say?
Blooper!
Blooper. What did I say?
Like you stayed with your wife, of course.
Oh, of course I stayed with my wife. I stayed with my wife in Mombasa. I just phoned out for a bit. So that's why my accent is a bit Mombasa. I can speak the normal one as well. But the accent just got into me. I love that accent. So yeah, if you see us speaking different languages, especially Punjabi, because with us, we always speak in Punjabi each other. We're forcing ourselves to talk to each other in English. We normally speak in Punjabi full time. So if we end up speaking, don't worry, we will not put music where we're talking. We'll actually just put subtitles so everyone can understand what we're trying to say.
Or we'll put music and we'll just be like...
Yeah.
If it doesn't, then you'll know, because I'll fail. But always before your set, pray to God. Every set. Because if you pray to God, you will make it. Hashtag Mr. UNLs. Strongman for Jesus. I'm going to go for three more. You could see I was probably leaning on one side because the right side of my back is not feeling good. But another three more reps and then I'm done. A session of squats, the legs are feeling tired. I'm gonna superset weighted chin ups with some weighted walks. Funny name, we'll show you what it is. So, weighted chin ups is the best exercise for the arms. I also use it for my lats when I engage the back, the arms, and generally it helps you because when you have stronger arms, you will press, your press will be stronger, your bench press and your log. So it's a good exercise to try out. we have set up a waiter's walk there. So it's a funny exercise. I'll demonstrate to you. So you've seen at restaurants when waiters have plates, and then they carry them like this, and they carry them fast. So we're basically doing that with the weight. So we are carrying it, pressing it, and then walking with the weight.
And, we don't make this at home. We don't make all this up. All this is there.
It's there. Yeah.
What he's saying is waiter's walk. He said it fast, so I'm saying it loud and clear. Waiter's walk. Waiter's walk. Search on it. Try not to do it. Okay, don't really. Try.
All these are strongman movements that
All of them are strongman movements.